Hello students, hope the part 1 of the video was useful to you. We will continue with the part 2. Let's see those questions in June 2019. Pi square is given as 96, R is equal to 8% compounded annually. Here the main clue is compounded annually. If the questioner has to give some twist, he'll give only year. Compounded annually, semi-annually, everything will be given. Since compounded annually is given, no need to do anything. Just take the IS 8% directly. Pi square is equal to 96 is given, so that directly apply and find the answer. 96 divided by 8% the whole square will be giving you the answer of 15,000. The next question. P is equal to 5,000. R is equal to 15%. T is equal to 4.5 years. They have given you just, it is a simple interest formula, so that directly calculate PNR by 100 or PRT divided by 100. You will get to the right answer of 3375. Just apply, multiply 5000 into 15% into 4.5 divided by 2 divided by 100. You will get to the right answer. The next question is, a sum of money amounts to rupees 6200 in 2 years and 7400 in 3 years as per simple interest. Here the clue is simple interest. They are asking you to find out the principal. In simple interest, the interest remains same over the period. That's a understanding which we have. Here what is given? A sum of money amounts to 6,200 in 2 years and 7,400 in 3 years. So that the incremental 1 year amount is 1,200. That will be the interest for the 3rd year. So 1200 is the interest for third year, means it will be the same for the first year and second year. So 1200 for first year, 1200 for second year, and 1200 for 3 years. So that total interest will be 3600. Your final amount is 7400 minus the initial, from the period, initial period onwards, you have got interest of 3600. If you reduce, you'll get to the principal amount. We are using this formula. Amount is equal to principal plus interest. I am using that formula. Just apply that, you will get to the right answer. Here amount is 7400. Total interest for 3 years is 1200 into 3600. Principal is a missing figure. There can be only one missing figure. Hence, you will find out the answer easily. The next question. The effective rate of interest does not depend upon. It actually depends upon amount of interest, number of conversion periods, and the option is none of the above, that will not be available. The amount of interest and number of conversion period is actually dependable factor. Hence, principal alone is not the depending factor, so that is the answer, which does not depend on amount of principal. In simple interest, the next question. In simple interest, the principal is 2000 and rate and time are the roots of equation. This is what they have given. Rate and time are the roots. That is the key they are given. How to find the roots of the equation? Here, what is the equation given? X square. It's x square minus 11x plus 30 is equal to 0. This is what they are given. Here, roots and enna solirukanga, what they are given? R is one root and time is other root. N is other root. Just simplify these things, you will get to the right answer. If you simplify, it will be x minus 5 and x minus 6. That will be equal to 0. Therefore, two factors are x is 5 and 6. How I got this is, if you multiply, you have to get 30. It's minus 5 and minus 6. This is how you have to get. So that x is 5 and 6. One is 5, one is 6. Take something like this. Your simple interest is equal to PNR divided by 100. P is nothing but what they have given is 2000. Here N is one thing and R is other thing, divided by 100. If you simplify, you will get to the right answer of 600. Right? That is one of the options given. Now we'll just go to the next question. The next question is, the certain sum of money become 692 in 2 years and 800 in 5 years. Here also it is given the simple interest. 692 in 2 years and 800 in 5 years. So that what is the difference amount? Difference amount is 800 minus 692. 800 minus 692 will give you 108. The 108 is the interest amount which you got over the period of 3 years. Correct? 108 divided by 3 means yearly interest will be 36. Now, what I am going to find out? The yearly interest is 36 means first 2 years I would have got 36 into 2, right? 72 rupees I would have got interest. Final principal I have got, final amount which I got in 2 years is 692. Interest which I got is 72. So that 692 minus 72 will give me principal. 692 minus 72 will give you 620. 620 is the right answer. Clear, everybody? Right. What is the present value? Next, present value of perpetuity. Perpetuity means nothing but annuity divided by interest rate. Annuity divided by interest rate is 5,000 per month. Here, convert everything into years or the interest rate into month. Everything should be in the same factors. If I take per month means 50,000 divided by 1% or else 6,50,000 into 12 divided by 12%. That will be giving you the right answer. The next question. The person wants to lease out a machine costing 5 lakh for a period of 10 years. It has fixed rental of 51,272 per annum. That is the annuity amount which you have got. Starting from the end of first year. Here this word gives you which formula you have to apply. So that this end of the formula, end of the year formula you have to use. Either the annuity at the beginning or annuity at the end. That's that formula you have to use accordingly. For that is a hint. Suppose the rate of interest is 10%, interest rate is also given, compounded annually, that clue is also given, which can be preferred, which is favorable. That's what the question is. Right. Everything is given. Now we have to compare and just see which is best. First thing, annuity is given, interest rate is given, you know the formula. What you have to find out? You have to find out the present value. We will just see. The present value will be like this. What is the formula for the present value at the end? Present value at the end will be like this. Present value at the end will be future value at the end divided by 1 plus I the whole power n. What is then future value? A into 1 plus I the whole power n minus 1 divided by I into 1 plus I the whole power n. But this is the formula. Just substitute here, you will get to the present value. Just compare the answer which you got with this 5 lakh. You will get to the right conclusion. Here leasing will be obviously preferable. When you solve, you will get to the answer of 3,15,044, which is obviously less than 5 lakh. Hence, you can prefer this leasing. The next question. The next question is, let a person invest a fixed sum at the end of each month in an account paying interest 12% per year, compounded monthly. If the future value of this annuity after the 12th payment is 55,000, then what is the amount invested every month? The question they are asking is the annuity, right? What is the amount invested every month? The annuity portion they are asking. Then what is the given thing? The future value at the end of 12th payment, or the future value at the end is given, 55,000 at the end of 12th payment. By n is 12, that is also given. Interest is 12% per year compounded monthly, hence it will be 1%. 12% divided by 12, then it will be 1%. So that just apply those things and you get to the formula, you will get to the right answer. The answer will be 4337. Just apply the formula, future value at the end formula, you will get to the right answer. The next, 11CX is equal to 11C2X minus 4. and x is not equal to 4 is the condition they have given. Find the value of 7cx. Now we are going to use a formula, the property of combination. Just see if this is there, what is the property? Just directly we can equate x is equal to 2x minus 4. That is one of the property. Other property is, if it is like this, ncr is equal to nck. If it is like this, there are two properties which we can do. One is r is equal to k. The other is r plus k is equal to n. There are two properties. We will just see. The condition which they have given is x is not equal to 4. Okay, well, then just take the question and write. See, 11cx is equal to 11c 2x minus 4. The first property, if we apply x is equal to 2x minus 4, just x comes this side, 4 comes that side, 2x minus x is equal to 4. That first property is not applicable. Then we are going to the second property, r plus k is equal to n. Then that means x plus 2x minus 4 will be equal to n. That if we use that formula, we will get to the right answer. What is the n? 11. X plus 2x is 3x minus 4 is equal to 11. 3x is equal to 15. X is equal to 5. Now just see, x is equal to 5, which is not equal to 4, correct? Then we can just apply there what they have asked, 7c5, right? 7c5 you write and find the answer. 7c5 is nothing but 21. You will get to the right answer. 7 factorial divided by 7 factorial, 7 minus 5 factorial into 5 factorial. You will get to the right answer. The next question is, which of the following is a correct statement? Just apply option testing methods, right? Put n is equal to 2. If you take 1, it will be 0. It will be somewhat confusing. Then just go for numbers. Just apply 2. The first formula, if you apply 2, 2p2 is equal to 2p1. Just apply the condition, whether c which is right or wrong. You apply the conditions for all the things. Here, obviously, the first answer itself will be right. 2p1, 2p2 will be equal to 2p1. That is the right answer. You will get to the right answer. The next question. If there are 40 guests in a party and each guest takes a handshake with the remaining guests, there is no such specific arrangement or pattern is given, hence go for combination. That's the only way. If something is specified, order of selection is specified, go for permutation. If nothing is there, go for combination. Right? Here, n will be 40, r will be 2. So that ncr, when you apply, it will be 40c2. Apply the formula, you will get to the right answer. In how many ways the crew of 8-oared boat be arranged so that if 3 of the crew can row only on the stroke side and 2 on the other side? Here I want to just clarify something. In a boat, what they are saying is 3 of them should be arranged in one side and 2 of them in the other side. This is what they have told, right? Now just see, in a boat, how the persons can be arranged? Equally, they have to arrange. If there are 8 persons, say 8 persons is there, you have to arrange 4 on one side and the 4 on other side. This is the only clue which we have. Let's see. This is a boat. Just I am saying, here 4 persons will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and here there will be 4 persons on each side. Here they have told 3 persons already there. Here they have told 2 persons already there. Now just see, they have fixed these persons. Now how many remaining persons will be there out of 8? 8 persons is there. Already you have fixed 3 here and then 2 here. So that only remaining persons will be 3. Now I am going to arrange these 3 persons. How I am going to arrange? If I am going to arrange this side first, I have to take only 4. Already I have taken 3. Appa remaining what I will do? Remaining what I can do is out of these 3 persons, I am going to select only 1 person. Correct? That is the probability which I will take. That is a combination which I will do. If one person is filled here, obviously the remaining will be 2. And the remaining, I have 2 places, I have to fill 2 persons. Hence 2C2 here. Right? The remaining persons alone can be arranged in these ways. Here 3 persons already fixed. Balance is 1. So that we have to select out of the 3, you have to select 1. Here out of the 2, you have to select 2. This is the thing. Okay. All these events occur simultaneously. Hence you have to product. So that 3C1 into 2C2. These 4 persons can be arranged in 4 factorial ways. Right? These 4 persons can be arranged in another 4 factorial ways. Hence your final answer will be 172A. In a boat, once again I am explaining, in a boat, 8 persons has to be arranged. They have told specifically 3 persons to be arranged here on one side and the other 2 on the other side. So that out of the 8, 3 and 2 if we subtract, you will have only 3 persons remaining. Out of the 3 persons, I have to select on one side 1 person and then other side I have to select 2 persons. I am using the combination formula 3C1 for selecting 1 person out of 3. Similarly, out of 2 I have to select 2. So that I am taking 2 ways. Now all the events occur simultaneously, hence I am multiplying the events so that you will get to the right answer. Hope all understood. The next question, the ratio of sum of n terms of 2AP is n plus 1 divided by n minus 1. That is, ratio is n plus 1 is to n minus 1. The ratio of mth term, this is what they have asked. How to solve this one? The ratio of sum of n terms, A1 and A2 are the first terms. D1, D2 are common differences. S1, SN1, SN2 are sum of 2APs. Now I am just substituting the question. The ratio of 2APs, sum of 2APs, sum of 2APs is 2N. N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into A1 D1 divided by N by 2 into 2A2 plus N minus 1 into D2 is in the ratio of N plus 1 divided by N minus 1. Now, this gets cancelled. I am taking in this way mth term. Then what is it they have given is, they have asked is mth term. Mth term will be A plus M minus 1 into D. This is right. Okay. I am converting everything in terms of this way. Yeah, dividing by 2. So that A1 plus N minus 1 divided by 2 into D1 divided by A2 plus N minus 1 divided by 2 into D2 will give you N plus 1 divided by N minus 1. Now just directly I am comparing. Just see here A plus N minus 1 into D. Similarly A plus N minus 1 into D. Now we can directly equate N minus 1 divided by 2 and M minus 1. Correct? On comparing these two things, I am just equating this portion with directly this portion. So that you will get N. N will be, N minus 1 will be 2M minus 2. N will be 2m minus 2 plus 1, so that n will be 2m minus 1. I am substituting this n value here. You will get 2m minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2m minus 1 minus 1. Plus 1 and minus 1 gets cancelled. 2m divided by 2m minus 2. All 2s are there, so that I am taking 2 as common. That can get cancelled, so that your answer will be m by m minus 1. Hope everybody is clear. Here the main technique is you have to take the equation in like this: a plus n minus 1 into d. If it is in that way, you can directly compare mth term as a plus m minus 1 into d. Hence, we can find directly the answer. This is how we have to solve these sums. The next question: in a GP, fourth term is 3. The product of first 7 terms. How to solve these sums? Just apply those techniques which you know directly. You will get to the right answer. Here, if you see, the fourth term is given. T4 is nothing but AR cube, right? AR cube is 4. That's what they have given. Right, AR4, product of first 7 terms. Product of first 7 terms is like this: A into AR into AR square into AR power 3 into AR power 4 into AR power 5 1, 2, 3 into AR power 6 will be what is the question? Product of first 6 terms. Now only AR power 3 is there. Just see, we can do like this: A into everything convert in terms of A and R. Here R 1, 2, 3, just we can add everything, right? 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15, 15 plus 6 is 21. Up A R power 21, A power 7, like this it will be there. Now just try to convert everything in terms of AR cube. Can we do? Yes, we can do. AR cube whole power 7 will be this thing, correct? If you take 7 commonly, then you will get AR cube, right? So that AR is given, 4 power 7 is the right answer. That's what you can find easily. The next question. Here the question is, fourth term is 3. Just substitute 4 in place of 3, you'll get to the right answer. Then what is given is 2 plus 6 plus 10 plus 14 plus 18 plus x and so on up to x is 882. Then find the value of x. Here I'm just reproducing the question once again. Here what is the question given is 2 plus 6 plus 10 plus 14 and so on up to x will be equal to 882. Here just see the difference. It will be 4. D will be 6 minus 2, that will be equal to 4. Everywhere it is 4. So that the series is in AP. First condition is to find whether it is in AP or GP. We have done. A is also there. D is also there. Sum is also there. Sn is also there. Now what is that they are asking is x is the thing they are asking. Whether you know how many terms are there? No, we don't know. There cannot be two missing figures. If you substitute the formula, you will be like getting like this: Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus l or 2a plus n minus 1 into d. When you expand that last term formula, you will get like that. Here if you apply n by 2 and then a plus l, l is x, two missing figures are there. Then how to find out? We will just take this way. Here if you see, tn last term will be here x, correct? Last term is nothing but a plus n minus 1 into d, right? Is equal to x. A is nothing but 2. 2 plus n minus 1 into d is 10 into 4 will be equal to x. So that if you simplify, x is equal to 2 plus 4n minus 4. Therefore, it will be 4n minus 2. X is equal to 4n minus 2. Just apply here. 882 is equal to n by 2 into 2 plus 4n minus 2. Plus 2 and minus 2 get cancelled. Here, 4n square divided by 2. It will be like this: 882. If you divide by 2, n square will be 441, n will be 21. You have found out n. Just substitute here. x is equal to 4 into 21 minus 2, x is equal to 84 minus 2, 82 is the right answer. There can be only one missing figure. First find n and then substitute the n in the x term. You will get to the answer of x. This is how you have to find out. The 27th question. Y is equal to 1 plus x square and so on up to infinity. Here if you see, see to that whether the series is in AP or GP first. Here if you see, it will be like this. First term, second, it will be in the ratio. Common ratio will be same. X divided by 1 is x. X square divided by x is x. Everything will be x. So that it is infinite, it is in GP. It goes on up to infinity. Use the sum to infinity formula. Sum to infinity is nothing but a by 1 minus r. Just substitute that, you will get to the right answer. A by 1 minus r, if you substitute, you will get to the right answer of a, y minus 1 divided by y. 28. Here, a is equal to set is given. B is equal to set of elements is given. C is also given. They are asking you to find out a minus b union c. First, find out a minus b. A minus b, eliminate all the common elements and then write only the elements pending remaining. Then take the union of c, you will get to the right answer. If a minus b, if you eliminate all the items, you will get 2, 6 and then 9 only. Here then c is already having 2, 6 and 8. Union of 2, 6, 9 and 2, 6, 8 is 2, 6, 8, 9. You will get to the right answer of c. Then 29th question. A is set of elements containing from 1 to 10. The relation is such that x plus y is equal to 10. If you add the two numbers, it should be equal to 10. That's the condition they have given. If you see, r is like that. That's what they are saying. X plus y. What elements if you add, you'll get 10. First, just to see. 5 plus 5 will be 10. 6 plus 4 will be 10. 7 plus 3 will be 10, 8 plus 2 will be 10. Like that, 9 plus 1 will be 10. These are the probabilities, right? Just I'm writing down. What is that given? R is like that, x comma y. X in y are such that x plus y is equal to 10. Now just see, what are the elements will give you 10? 5 comma 5, 5 plus 5, 6 plus 4, 7 plus 3, 8 plus 2, 9 plus 1. These elements will give you 10, right? Clear? These are the elements which will give you 10. What is that they are asking is R inverse order domain. Domain is nothing but first elements. That is domain. Here R is, R we know. What is R inverse? R inverse is nothing but inverse is gonna. Domain and codomain to be inverse. Here 5 comma 5, nothing you can know. Here 6 comma 4 can be written as 4 comma 6. 7 comma 3 can be written as 3 comma 7. 8 comma 2 can be written as 2 comma 8. 9 comma 1 can be written as 1 comma 9. Now domain represents the first elements. Take and write the first elements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Therefore, these are the domain of R inverse. Domain of R inverse is nothing but these things, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm going to the next question. The number of subsets of a set, 3, 4, and 5. Subsets, we know the formula 2 power n is a formula for subsets. If it is proper subset, 2 power n minus 1. Just have a careful thing here. They can twist their way. 3, 4, 5, there are 3 elements, therefore n is equal to 3, 2 power n is 2 power 3, 2 power 3 is nothing but 8, you will get to the right answer. There ends your part 2, hope this video is useful to you. Thank you.